Yeah, welcome you all for the last unit or last topic of this particular Verilog, HDL Verilog. So in this last part of the unit, I can say, we are studying about the logic synthesis. So logic synthesis is, I can say it as a reverse engineering. So here, reverse engineering means whatever we have done up till now, we are just analyzing this part in a reverse way. That's it. I repeat, whatever we have done up till now, we are just going in a reverse way. Up till now, what we have done, we were being asked to design something, and we were having, let me just tell you. So till now, what we were doing is, problem statement, I can say. After that, we were designing truth table. After that, logic expression. After logic expression, you can say here K-map also. Okay. After logic expression, then you were constructing your design block. Then after design block, you are writing Verilog code, right? So this was the process. No? It's a forward process. Now in synthesis, we are doing exactly the reverse engineering. Reverse engineering means what we are doing is we are giving you Verilog code or pseudo code. Verilog code comes first. Okay. Verilog code comes first. Here problem statement, here Verilog code comes first. After that, you have to use all these things here also. Ultimately, you should come up with a design block. Design block is your output. Okay. So in synthesis, if I treat this as a block, in this chapter, what we are doing is at the input side, think that it is the input side, you will be having Verilog. Okay, at the output side, you should write a logic diagram. Okay, so this is what we are doing in logic synthesis. I hope the things are clear. So before we proceed with that particular interesting topic, we shall understand the fundamentals of the logic synthesis. Of course, here I have been very crisp. Of course, I have taken some long looking statements just to give you that notes in the form of the slide. Okay. So what is logic synthesis actually? First we will go with the textbook meaning or textbook statement. Later on we'll understand in our own way. So logic synthesis is a process of converting a high level description of design into an optimized gate level representation. What we are doing? It's a process of what? Converting. What you are converting? High level description of the design. Into what? Into gate level representation. Very simple, right? It's a process. It's something, some process is right. What process it is? It is converting. What it is converting? High level description. High level description maybe? Verilog code, it is a high level description. VHDL code, it's a high level description. Verilog code you'll be writing for what? We'll be writing Verilog code of the design, right? So that's why of the design. Into an optimized, we'll come to this optimized later. Okay, into what we are converting? Gate level representation. It's a logic circuit. That's it. Right? So we are doing this with the help of what? With the help of standard cell libraries. Standard cell libraries means all gates like AND gate, OR gate, XOR gate, adders, subtractors, multipliers, whatever standard cell libraries that are provided that we need, using those, we are doing this. And certain design constraints. What are these design constraints? I may give the design constraint as, I want the delay only this much. I want the power utilization only this much. I may say that area given is only this much. I may tell that you cannot have more gates. You cannot have more time. You cannot cross more cost. Anything may be the constraint, so that those are the design constraints. Okay, see how we made this system. We broke this statement into piece by piece, and we understood. First, we understood that logic synthesis is a process. It's a process. Oh, what process is this? It's a process of converting. What it is converting? It is converting Verilog code into what? Into a logic circuit. Into a logic circuit. So to convert this, what all things it is using? It is using AND gate, OR gate, adder, all these things in the terminology we call it as standard cell libraries. These all are standard cells. Okay, these are available in the libraries. So standard cell libraries. You may ask, like, adder is not there. How can you write it? So when you are using the operator called plus, so when plus operator you write, if Verilog is recognizing it, then of course there will be some defined logic. Defined Verilog code working backside. So that's why I have taken even that. Even you will be having MUX, many more. Those are all called as standard cell libraries because these standard cells are already present in the library. Okay? And certain design constraints. You will be having certain design constraints, right? You cannot say that design something, I will give you root size of area, you can have that much big chip. Cannot say that, right? Your chip should be small, so that is related to area. And you cannot say that, okay, I am able to design this logic, but the power requirement is equivalent to how much power is needed to run a refrigerator. No, that's not feasible, right? You should work with limited power, right? So then you cannot say that my logic works, but when you give input, it will produce output after 1 hour. Is it okay? No, it is not okay. Things should have restricted it. And you cannot say that, of course, the logic that you are expecting, my logic, I have designed that logic, my circuit is working according to it. But the thing is, to implement it, the cost needed is 2 lakhs. Nobody will purchase it, right? Even that is a constraint. You cannot exceed too much of cost. And on the other day, you can say that, I have a logic, but to implement it, to bring it in the physical form, I need at least 2 years, right? It's earlier, time to market is too high. So you cannot ignore that. So all these are called as design constraints, right? So let us put all together at one place now, and we will read this thing. Logic synthesis is process of converting a high level description like Verilog and HDL of what? Of the design that you are focusing on into an optimized, keep pending, gate level representation, that is logic circuit. Optimized means finest or efficient, you can say, optimized gate level representation. Given, what all things are given to me? As a resource, standard cell libraries are given to me. With that, we have also been given some constraints. What are those design constraints? Like delay, power, area, cost, time to market, and I hope the things are clear. Very important definition, very important concept. Logic synthesis. I hope it is clear. Now here, what are standard cells? So this thing is being explained. Standard cell libraries have simple cells such as logic gates, AND OR gate, macro cells, adders, MUX, flip-flops and so on. Standard cell library is also known as technology library. Remember this. This word you will hear in your next semester in the course called VLSI design, technology library. Okay, so technology library, to brief you more about it, like we have a technology library like 180 nanometer, 90 nanometer, 60 nanometer, 65, 45 nanometer. So this nanometer, whatever I'm saying, it is a transistor size. Okay, it's a transistor size. For example, you have all studied about MOSFET, right? MOSFET will be having, it will be having gate, right? So source, drain, this is gate, rough diagram, okay? Source, drain, gate, and here this is a channel. I hope you all remember it, right? Channel, analog electronics. So this channel length defines the technology node. So 180 nanometer means what? 180 nanometer is a channel length. Channel length means what? It is the distance between source and drain of a transistor. Okay. So when I say 180 nanometer, technology node or technology library means the cell the AND gate, the OR gate, the flip-flop, the adder, all these are implemented using a transistor, and that transistor will be having the channel length of 180 nanometer. That's the meaning. Okay, so this is what we call it as technology library or node. Very basic. Okay, please remember this. When I say 90 nanometer technology node, the meaning is all these standard cell library things, and gate or gate mux, adder, all these circuitries at transistor level are implemented with a transistor whose channel length is 90 nanometer. Like that, we have 65 nanometer, 45 nanometer. Even we have reached below 14 nanometer. Below 40 nanometer processors are already out in the market. Intel processors. Okay, you can expect, you know, below 8 nanometer things in the market very soon. Below 8 nanometer. 8 nanometer means the distance between source and drain is so tiny that it is in terms of nanometer. That's why we call it as nanotechnology, right? Fine. So this is what is a standard library. Okay. So let us, you will learn it in VLSI subject. Let us concentrate here. So logic synthesis. So from here, I'll just go back to the history. Now you understood what is logic synthesis. Okay. So now you'll just go back to the history. What actually we are doing? Logic synthesis always existed even in the days of schematic gate level design. Means these were the earlier processes. But it was always done inside the designer's mind. Designer's mind means it is user or you people. You people, the one who are designing the circuits, those are designers. Designer's mind means something is going in your mind. Whenever a task is given, you will end up thinking something. Some thought process will be going. That is what we are pointing out at designer's mind. Okay. So what is that is going on? That we will understand. So, whenever a task was given, whenever the Verilog code was written, and I wanted a hardware out of it. So, you have written a Verilog code, right? Verilog code is in terms of script, but you want to design a hardware which is physically present. You want to bring it onto the FPGA. To bring it, there will be lot of processes will be happening. So, that processes. Now Xilinx is doing automatically. Initially, now Xilinx is doing automatically. But in earlier days, there was no Xilinx. These things, whatever Xilinx is automatically doing, this was supposed to be done in the designer's mind itself. Right? So that process I'll tell you. Now, if you why we are learning all old things, that might be the question in your mind. If you learn all the old things, then you will understand how Xilinx is interpreting your code. How Xilinx is able to understand the Verilog code and it is generating the hardware on the FPGA. How it is able to download your code onto the FPGA. That you will understand. So that's why we are able to understand how designers were thinking in their mind. What was the thought process that was going on? So that we are discussing now. Okay? So just the designer would first understand the architectural description. The designer, once they look into the Verilog code, they used to understand like what it is giving, what it is taking, what are the inputs, what are the outputs, what actually it is doing. That the designer mind should have thought. Then he would consider design constraints such as timing, area, testability, power. Then the designer would partition the design into high level blocks. Draw them on a piece of paper or a computer terminal and describe the functionality of a circuit. This was the high level description. Think, if Xilinx was not there, you are writing a Verilog code in your paper. Once you write a Verilog code in your paper, you should think, in FPGA, if I want to code it, then the first thing is, this Verilog code gives results into so and so blocks. For example, if I ask you to write a counter design, what you will do? You will just write count is equal to count plus 1 at pause edge of the clock. That's it you are writing. But what all internal circuitry will be needed, means logic circuit is needed. You have to go back to the digital circuit design of your previous semester course. Right? So that fundamentals comes into place. So designers would partition the design into a high level block. So counter equal to count plus 1. So it means 4 bit counter. So 4 bit counter is a high level block for me. And then we were driving that on the piece of paper or computer terminal. Describe the functionality. So functionality is count is incrementing. This was high level. Next, each block would be implemented on hardware drawn schematic using cells available in the standard library. So that counter is broken into flip-flops. That flip-flops again broken into the standard cell libraries that are available, AND gate, OR gate, all these things. So those are broken into pieces, and all these things were written on the paper. The last step was the most complex process in the design flow. That is, it was coming and consuming lot of time. That was, you have to try hard to come at the optimized gate level of representation, meeting all the design constraints. You might implement logic. See, nowadays I am telling, once you're out of this college, you will end up with some job. So once you are in that job, think that you got a post of design engineer or development engineer, so whatever, in that field, program, whatever. So there, you will find in n number of people who can write a code. You will find n number of people who can design the logic. But company needs a people who does the same things in a different way. What is that different way? Is the optimized solutions. Optimized solutions we need. Okay, for particular problem you will be having 10 different solutions. Out of that, the optimized solutions. The optimization means it might be like, for example, when we speak about electronics chip. So first thing is area should be less. Second thing is it should consume less power. Third thing is it should execute, its speed should be high, means delay should be less. Then the cost should be less. Then early to the market should be, I should produce in huge number easily. Then testing phase should be, testability is also important. If I want to test that circuitry, that should be easily available. So all these things we need to check. All these things should be satisfied, should be ticked. Such should be my design, which is very hard to get. It is very hard to get. Fine? So that's why. So what you are supposed to do is, here it is called as a complex process design flow. Complex process in design. So this was a complex process. Now why are not worrying about this complex process nowadays? Because Xilinx is doing it. Once you just click on synthesis after writing very long code, all the process is done by itself. You are able to see the RTL logic, technology logic. Automatically with your code, the logic circuit diagram is getting prepared. So that is the beauty of design. Okay. So this is about the logic synthesis. Okay. So now we shall understand the next one. What are the impact of this logic synthesis? What were the disadvantages? That is what we are doing. There were lot of disadvantages. Okay. So these disadvantages, let us understand. So impact of logic synthesis. Of course, I did not made a point because it was huge, and I just wanted to, be very brief. So first is, it was taking too much time. The designers might, without Xilinx, what are the problems we were facing? Too much time. Complex. It was too complex, right? And not accurate. And it varies too much. Varies with person to person. Okay, but Xilinx is not like that. Then debugging is too difficult. Debugging is hard. Then if you want to change certain things in your code, it is very difficult. Again, you need to follow all this process. So not flexible. And think that that particular designer left the company, and that work was given to the next, work is given to the next particular follower, successor. It is very hard for him to adapt to the new things, adaptability issue. Because what that designer have thought in that in his mind while designing that particular thing, who knows, right? So there is no standardized process, no standardization. And many more, I can have many more, right? I can have many more. So this is the impact of the logic synthesis in designer's mind, with designer's mind. Okay, so to just overcome it, what we did is design their minds as a logic synthesis tool. Let us understand what, in the same way, what the designers might think, in the same way, people thought to automate it. So, designers mind as synthesis tool. Designers mind as synthesis tool. What we were thinking, we make designers to think in the same fashion. So that in a single click, it does what designers were thinking in their mind. This is what is called automation. You may be thinking that automation field is affecting only civil engineers and mechanical engineers. No, not at all. It is even affecting computer science as well as electronics people also. See, the electronics engineer would have been huge in demand if there was no automation process, because thinking all these things in mind, having thought process, having logic building capacity by this way, you will find very less people in the market. But having the Xilinx tool, in place of 10 designers, I need one designer, because company tells that, okay, you can, the time taken by the designers to define the logic, you can do 10 such synthesis using Xilinx tool, because that is what is the result of automation. So whenever there is automation, it will eat up the job, right? It will eat up the job of the not so smart people, but it will give the job, it will give the opportunity to the smart employees, smart engineers, I can say. If you are smart enough, you will definitely have an edge opportunity in the automation era. But if you want to be like just as others, then this automation will definitely kill you and kill the job. So now we need smart engineers rather than a traditional conventional engineer. Okay? Because we have lot of automation. Just keep this in your mind. I'm telling you, very important for that. So let us come to this point. So in the same fashion, how designers' mind was thinking, in the same fashion we shall proceed for logical synthesis. Architectural description. This is your very long quote. Partitioning into the high level blocks. Like this is, you are dividing the logic. Like, so counter followed by flip flops followed by basic gates. So those things, partitioning. Okay. Then designer's mind starts thinking. Designer's mind should keep certain things in the mind. What is that? Partitioning in mind. Think that I'm designing a counter, 4-bit counter. What all things should be in my mind? I should be having the conception that counter needs the sub-blocks called flip-flops, and flip-flops needs the basic gates, MUX or whatever. Of course, MUX is, without MUX also I can do, but with MUX also I can design, right? So all such basic gates we need. So that should be there in the designer's mind. Then what are the other things? Design constraints. These design constraints should also kept in the mind, right? You cannot simply say that I just want to design logic. I don't mind whether it is efficient or optimized or it is following the things, rules or those things. If I don't mind, then you cannot become a good engineer. Okay, so remember that. Then what are standard cells are available with me? That also you should keep in mind. You cannot simply say that I need those sophisticated things which are not there in the standard cell. No, not that, technology dependent. Okay. Having all these things in the mind, then he will design a gate level representation. He will start designing by arranging all these basic gates to form the flip flop, arranging all these flip flops to form the counters. That will be done. And once it is done here, we need to test, we need to check. This is called testability. This is testing phase. Testing engineers do this. Meet the design constraints or not, that we will check. So these design constraints we are knowing, that we will check here. If it is meeting, the job is done. If it is not meeting, then again, design iterations means designers should again think. That is the meaning of iteration, should again think. So this process is too hectic. This is a complex process. This itself is a complex process. Okay, this is everything, everybody can design the logic, but to think why design constraint is not matching, again rectifying it and doing it, that is a complex process. Okay, so that is done. Again, gate level representation is changed. Now we are checking the design constraints. If it is met, then it is done. We are done. So what will be the resultant? The resulting thing is optimized gate level representation. We got a optimized gate level representation. That is what is a requirement. That is what is a needed. Okay. So this is a designer's points as a logical synthesis. Now, after this analysis of the designer's mind as a logic synthesis tool, now basic computer-aided logic synthesis process. Let me take very well-known tool for us, Xilinx synthesis, because we are using that. I don't have any special kind of affection towards Xilinx. You can use any other tool also, but we have that licenses in our college, and they are why I appreciate them, because they are providing the evaluation version for free. We can install it in laptop and we can work in many things at our own places. So that's why I appreciate. So Xilinx is nothing but it's a computer-aided logic synthesis tool. It's a tool. So this does this process. So what is Xilinx doing inside? Architectural description, Verilog code, or RTL, or I can say HDL logic, HDL Verilog file. High level description. That is itself is a high level description. Architecture means what actually it is doing. High level description is itself is your Verilog code. After that, computer aided logic synthesis. You will find the synthesis right in the process window of your Xilinx. Right, that is the same synthesis. When I synthesis, you have never provided as design constraints. Right, you have never provided. But there is an option to provide constraints. Just below the synthesis, you have an option called implement constraints. If you have any constraint provided, we are not providing any constraints, so that's why everything is easily synthesized. If you provide some constraints, then it is not so easy to provide something. If I tell you that, design a simple full adder which should take only this much delay to get resolved, but that becomes very difficult. That synthesis process becomes definitely difficult. Okay, so I am not providing any design constraints till now, because we are at the beginner level, right? So if we provide even that, it should be fine. And standards and libraries definitely present, because we are selecting while designing, while selecting the FPGA there, we are selecting what FPGA, VSGL standard or Verilog standard should follow in that particular thing, the respective library files data. This happens automatically. Okay, this you have to provide if you have any design. So with that, if you just click on synthesis, it will directly produce optimized gate level. Directly it will produce. Of course, if still there is a chance that it will not meet the constraints. Now, if it is not meeting the constraints, you have no option on working here. You have to go back to the Verilog code itself, VHDL code itself. There only you have to change your code. And again, you need to synthesize and then check whether it is following the design constraints. You have to change your Verilog code rather than scratching your head in all this, logic synthesis process. You have to just change the code accordingly. Then, if it is working, then we'll go further. If it is not working again, we have to go back here. And this process is not as complex as earlier in the previous time. It is not as complex as this. Okay, you can change definitely because it is high level description, right? You can definitely change certain part of the code where that constraint is not. So if testing is failed, then again you have to go for the coding. If testing is clicked, then go for the next. So in the company, what happens is architectural description is done by the project manager. This is done by the designers, programmers, and then this is done by the tool that you are working, and this is done by the testing engineer. Testing engineer check in all the different ways whether it is working fine or not. If somewhere in 99% it is fine and 1% is not working, means it will be directly sent to the designer back. So that's why designer and testing engineer, always there will be a fight between them. So he will be very strict to check all these things, but he has to work too hard. So that's why designers, programmers or developers will be having high packet salary compared to the testing engineers. Your testing is also important nowadays, because testing is also not easy. Now you are at the beginning stage, you feel that testing is not that important. You are just testing it. It's like evaluation process. But even this has lot of logic. One big subject you will have as elective in your final semester, final year. That is called DFT. DFT stands for Design for Testability. test also you have to design certain logic, because just think, if I am designing 256 bit adder, if I am designing 256 bit means how much? It is hardly I can say how many bytes, certain bytes, okay, don't worry about it. So you have to give all the test case inputs to it and have to check. It will be too much of test cases. So we'll just have to design certain logic for even testing, because you cannot give all the input cases, right, to test. So that also is a big field, right? So don't, I'm not underestimating this one, right? Next comes place and route. This is a work of physical engineer means the one who works on real things. Up till here it is only in the computer. Now here it is a real FPGA, hardware engineer, physical or hardware, I can say. Hardware engineer, right? Hardware, bringing onto the FPGA. That is also a big process. Placing and routing. What is place and route? That we will analyze first. I think I need an additional slide. Let me just take an additional slide. Are you there? Here today is full of, this session is full of, what I can say, practical things. I hope you are not bored. So you have to take it, learn it with interest. So that's what is my request. If you have any doubts, please come up in the chat box. Are you following what I'm telling, or are you feeling bored of these technical steps or theoretical steps? Please reply. Are you following? Please reply. Respond. Yeah, thank you. You're following. See, in this chapter, we are discussing a lot of things. What is happening in the what is happening in the industries or that are focused by you in the very next year, right? From 6th semester onwards, your placement starts. A lot of industries come there. What all different roles that are possible in this particular field? That you should know, right? Designers, developers, programmers, testing. Only this much you know. You have not heard of design for disability. You had not heard of something called physical design engineers, right? So all those engineers are also required, right? So now I was telling about place and route, right? Place and route. Let me tell you what it is. So once Verilog code, you had Verilog code first written in the Xilinx. Xilinx produced a certain synthesis information. Synthesis is done, means you have some hardware in the Xilinx software itself, some things design block connect like this, all these things is produced. Now place and route means this particular design block in the FPGA that we have, think that it is FPGA. Same FPGA I think. Is that FPGA we are using? Spartan 6. So in this FPGA, where I shall place this block? We'll be having lot of logic blocks, which is divided like this. Lot of all. Each block will be a logic block. Okay. So these CLBs we call it as. So here, if I place, I should make sure that my input pins are available here, right? So I'll place my logic here in the FPGA. That also I can decide, or else automatically it will do that before. If you want to optimize, you can do that also. Routing means connection. Routing means connection. Connection between port, connecting with the ports. So if your port is here, then routing becomes too much difficult. So your port selection, your placement should be such that ports, output ports, input ports, all the clock, power supply, everything should be near. So if the path is not long, then you will reduce the delay. So that's our advantage. So that's why try keeping all these things very nearer as possible. When you place very nearer, then there will be some other difficulty. Let us not discuss it. This is the meaning of placement. Okay. So we have understood placement. This is the work of physical design, physical engineer. Next comes, I just give a start to this. This is a very interesting part of this particular chapter. Okay, so here what we are doing is, we are giving you a Verilog statement and you need to do the work of Xilinx. Xilinx was doing this automatically. When you synthesize, when you click on the button called synthesize, in the process window, this was getting ready by default, by automatically. Now I want you people to do it. This is what I was calling it as a reverse engineering. Reverse process of what we have done whole of the semester. Right? Very interesting. Now, this might be feeling very easy for you. Assign out equal to A ampersand B, or with C means it is as good as writing out is equal to A dot B, or means however writing plus plus C. This is what we are writing. Here I need AND gate, I implemented AND gate. Then whatever output I were getting, that I was ORing with, C. I am ORing with C. This is OR gate, I am getting the output. Right? Very simple, right? You may feel that science is only doing this and you and I can do it. You and you can do it. Right? So this is a simple code, that's why you know Xilinx is also able to do and we are also able to do. But as the things get complex, see just here. If A, B, C and out are two bits, and if I have defined this out is equal to A ampersand B odd with C, see how it changed. I have to do a bitwise operation because this is a bitwise operation. First I'll consider the least significant bit, then I'll consider the most significant bit. Least significant bit of A, that we call it as A of A0, B of 0 is added, its output is OR with C of 0 and I get the least significant bit of the output, right? So this is a design, half design. Next is most significant bit. So this is with least significant bit, this is with most significant bit. We have to do the both process. Here A of 1, B of 1 is added, its output is added with, is OR with C of 1. You will get the most significant bit of the output, right? So compared to this, this took little more time of you, like how Xilinx is doing this process. Now if I just increase the complexity, if I just write like this, C underscore out comma sum concatenation equal to A plus B plus C addition. So what is this? It is a full adder, right? You have to understand that it is a full adder. Here A is a single bit, B is a single bit, carry input is a single bit. So three bits are being added. So I need sum of single bit to save the sum of it. And if there is a carry out, I want one extra bit. Hence, I'm using concatenation operator and I'm joining C out with the sum and keeping the C out in the most significant bit. This is nothing but a full adder. So hence this circuit is full adder. That's it. So here you have XOR, this is XOR, this is AND. This is a half adder, and this is a half adder, and with these two half adders, I'm taking the carry out here, C1, C2, I'm getting the C out. Okay, so this is a full adder using half adder. So any ways you can do, any ways you can do. Okay, so it's nothing but a full adder. So Xilinx will do it automatically. Next comes MUX. So in MUX, what we are doing here, out, first you should understand that it is MUX. It is a ternary operator, right? Or else I can say it as conditional operator or ternary operator. What it is doing, there is some variable, let me call it a select line. This select line I am testing, if it is true, it should be executed. If it is false, it should be executed. I mean, this should be assigned to out. So if S is equal to 1, out is equal to I. If S is equal to 0, out is equal to I. So what is this logic? This logic is itself a MUX. That's it. This you should define. Now you, it is simple, you can easily identify. Think that there is some complex design, your project is done. Then it will be very complex. Right? So now MUX design. This is a MUX design. You just here. This is AND gate, AND gate. So I naught ANDed with S bar plus I1 ANDed with yes, that's it. Out is equal to I naught ended with S bar plus I1 ended with yes. Simple yes. OR gate is also different. This is itself is a out. Simple MUX. This is quite synthesis. You have a Verilog instruction, you have a Verilog code at the input. You have to produce its synthesis, you have to produce its RTL schematic. This is what we call it as RTL schematic. Okay? RTL schematic. Next, if else statement. If else statement, see if S is equal to 1, I1, if S is equal to 0, I1. is a cyclone. What is this meaning? The meaning is again MUX. Right? Again MUX. I might have something different, but you understand this code. This is as good as behaving in this manner. Select line, you have two inputs. One is select line, and the other two inputs are I naught, I one, and this is the output. And this is just 2:1 MUX. When S is equal to 0, I naught should be assigned to out. When S is equal to 1, I naught should be assigned to out. That is what is happening. When S is equal to 0, I naught is assigned to out. When S is equal to 1, I one is assigned to out. So MUX, design the MUX circuitry. That is what is done, nothing but RTL schematic. And which is that process which is doing this conversion from regular code to this RTL schematic? It's the process called synthesis. That is what is the chapter. I hope you are getting it. Okay, we will just go on increasing this complexity. Now, case statement. Again, everywhere I have taken MUX just for understanding the beginning level. Case yes. If S is 0, out is. If S is 1, out is 1. So again, a MUX. It's just a MUX. Case statement. Okay? Simple. Now, like this, we shall take loop statement, always statement, sequential statements, and thus we shall analyze how to do all these things using synthesis process. Not automatically using Xilinx, but like the thought process that was happening in the designer's mind. Okay, that's it for today. We shall discuss the rest of the things in the next session, that is on tomorrow. If you have any doubts, please come up in the chat.